We now discuss the solution of a problem from the section Linear Algebra. The problem is based on linear dependence and linear independence in R power n. This question has appeared in CSIR National Eligibility Test held on 30th November 2020 and it is from the section B. The problem is, let S is equal to the set consisting of U1, U2, etc., UK be a subset of non-zero vectors from R power n. Consider the two statements given below. Statement 1, if S is linearly dependent set in R power n, then UK is a linear combination of U1, U2, etc., UK minus 1. Statement 2, if S is linearly independent set in R power n, then K less than n. Which of the following statements is true? Options. Option 1, statement 1 is false and statement 2 is true. Option 2, statement 1 is true and statement 2 is false. Option 3, both statement 1 and statement 2 are false. Option 4, both statement 1 and statement 2 are true. Now let's recall the concepts of linear dependence and linear independence in a vector space. An indexed set S is equal to the set consisting of U1, U2, etc., UK. It is an indexed set, indexed by 1, 2 up to K in R power n is said to be linearly independent if the vector equation alpha 1 u1 plus alpha 2 u2 plus etc. plus alpha k uk is equal to the zero vector, has only the trivial solution, that is alpha 1 is equal to alpha 2 is equal to etc. is equal to alpha k is equal to the scalar 0. S is linearly dependent if there exist scalars alpha 1, alpha 2, etc., alpha k, not all of them 0, such that their linear combination is the 0 vector, that is alpha 1 u1 plus alpha 2 u2 plus etc. plus alpha k uk is the 0 vector. Let's now discuss the solution of the problem in detail. Statement 1, let's now consider statement 1. It states, if S is linearly dependent set in R power n, then UK, the last element, is a linear combination of its predecessors U1, U2, etc., UK minus 1. Now, this statement is not true. To substantiate this, we give a counter example. Let S is equal to the set consisting of U1, U2, U3 be an indexed subset of R cube, where U1 is 100, U2 is equal to 200, U3 is equal to 001. Obviously, U2 is 2 times U1 and thereby S will be linearly dependent. Clearly, S is linearly dependent. Why? Because 2 times of U1 plus minus 1 times of U2 plus 0 times of U3 is the 0 vector. Yes. So we have scalars, not all of them 0, but their linear combination is 0 vector. Therefore, it is dependent. Suppose that the statement 1 is true. That means this last U3 can be written as a linear combination of U1 and U2. then if the statement 1 is true, then U3, that is 0, 0, 1, is a linear combination of U1, 1, 0, 0, comma, U2 is equal to 2, 0, 0. That is, U3 is equal to 0, 0, 1 is equal to alpha 1 U1 plus alpha 2 U2 is equal to multiply and add. You will get the triad alpha 1 plus 2 alpha 2 0 0. Equating the corresponding components, we get alpha 1 plus 2 alpha 2 is equal to 0. And when you equate this third component on both sides, you will get 0 is equal to 1, which is absurd. That is, the statement 1 is true is not true. That is, it is false. Therefore, the statement 1 is false. So let's look at the options 2 and 4. Both is in both these options, statement 1 is true is stated. So, but the statement 1 is false. So therefore, the options 2 and 4 are not true. Now let us consider statement 2. If S is equal to U1, U2, UK is linearly independent set in R power n, then K less than n. Suppose the statement 2 is true. That is, if S is linearly independent set in R power n, then the number of elements present in S is less than n. That is, the order of S is less than n. Now, you take a basis B of R power n. And what is a basis? A basis is a maximal linearly independent subset of R power n. So, a basis is linearly independent. Then, by the above statement, order of B must be less than n. The order of B is less than n, which is not true. Which is not true. Because n less than n, which is not true. So, therefore, the statement 2 is false. So, let's look at the options. The option 1, statement 2 is true is given, but it is false. Therefore, the option 1 is not true. And the option 3, wherein it says both statement 1 and statement 2 are false, is true. So, finally, both the statements 1 and statement 2 are false. So, thus, the option 3 is true. So, that is the discussion of the problem from the linear algebra, which is based on the concepts of linear dependence and independence in R power n. I am sure that you have understood the solution of this problem. I wish you all the best. Thank you.